Hi guys, this is Sushant Kochar and today we are going to talk about if it is a good thing to have high metabolism. By metabolism, we are referring to BMR over here. So is it a good thing to have high metabolism? See, people think it is a really good thing because by having high BMR, high metabolism, they can eat whatever they want and they would not gain fat even by eating it. Okay, I understand your happiness, and so the sad part for low metabolism guys, low BMR guys, is that it is hard for them to lose weight. Easily they get to gain fat, they can gain fat easily. They can't eat a lot of food. If they are foodie, they can't eat a lot of food, or they can't be eating their favorite foods like cakes, pastries, pizzas and burgers. Or if they can, they cannot eat big portions of them. So for the sad part of the low metabolism guys and for the happy part of the high metabolism guys, here's one thing I want to mention. So if you're a high BMR guy and thinking that, oh, I have high metabolism, I can eat whatever I want, I would not gain fat, or no one can defeat me kind of a thing, then let me tell you, maybe you're eating a lot of cakes, pastries, ice cream, burgers, pizzas, and you're not gaining fat. True, but gaining fat is not the only parameter to tell that anyone is healthy or unhealthy. If you're eating all of those junk foods I just mentioned, you are internally harming your body, which might not appear outside in the name of fat, but you are definitely internally harming your body. So not gaining fat is not just the criteria to keep eating whatever you want to. You're still harming your body. I'll talk about how you're harming your body in the future videos, but for now you know that you're harming your body. So you are having a high BMR does not give you full freedom to eat whatever you want and as much as you want. Even you should be eating healthy. Okay, now as we talked about the sad part of the low metabolism guys, now we will talk about the disadvantages of the possible disadvantages of high metabolism guys. Okay, so it is hard for you to gain weight, very obvious and very known problem. You have to eat too much to gain weight. Many times you have to eat more than your hunger to gain weight. You should not eat more than your hunger. You should not eat when you're not hungry. Okay, the rules of your body, do what your body says. Okay, if you are not eating properly for some days, then you quickly tend to lose weight, which I would not say is a good thing, because one should not be easily losing weight in a matter of days. One should be able to maintain the weight that a person wants to maintain. So if you're not eating properly for a few days, many times you start losing weight quickly. Now the third one is a case like hyperthyroid, where the BMR is too high. Your body makes a lot of thyroid hormones and your BMR shoots up. And as your BMR goes up, your body starts to burn a lot of energy. And when your body burns a lot of energy and you're not able to give it back that much energy through food, you start experiencing significant weight loss. That weight loss is from fat loss, muscle loss, all sorts of weight loss. So it could be all sorts of sort of weight loss. So it is major weight loss. So here is an example where BMR is high, but it is not beneficial, it is harmful, it is a disease. Now the fourth one is lifespan. Okay, so first of all, think of it as in this way. So you have a body, you feed it every day. Now the low BMR guys would not feed it as much as the high BMR guys. So your body has to put in effort to digest the food that you give it. Now think of the body as a machine. There is a machine, you ask it to, the high BMR guy asks it to digest a lot of food. So the high BMR guy asks the body to do a lot of work, as compared to the low BMR guy who would not ask the body to do so much of digestion. So basically, the high BMR guy is using the machine more. So if you're using a machine more than someone else, then it is highly likely that your machine would give up before that someone else's machine gives up. So what that means is, if you give your body lesser amount of work, a lesser amount of things to digest, it should be going to be work longer. So basically you are going to live longer. If you give your body too much work to do, it is perhaps going to live shorter. Now, what does science has to say on this? See, caloric restriction, where you eat less, or you eat, you either don't eat for a whole day or multiple days, or you basically eat less in one day or multiple days. So that is caloric restriction. I'll talk about this in detail in my future videos, but for now, understand that making your body work less has proven to increase the lifespan in a lot of animals. This has been proven by science, and science thinks that it is likely likely to be same in humans. So also for humans, if you are eating lesser, you are more likely to increase your lifespan. Increasing lifespan does not mean that if cow has a lifespan of like 20-25 years, it is going to live for 100 years. No, if on average a cow is living 17-18 years, if you make them eat a bit lesser, not too less, a bit lesser, then perhaps they would live for 21-22 or 24-25 years. Similarly for humans, if nowadays humans are dying at 70-75-80, and they could live up to 100-110-120 years, so eating lesser could take you from 75-85-90 or so, or maybe 100. Now, what religious or spiritual texts have to say about this? So in those some of those texts, what comes is, staying hungry for one day is the best medicine. You drink just water in that day, and that too is optional. That is best medicine for staying hungry for one day. And the ideal number to do, how many days should you be doing it? So 6 days a month, not necessarily consecutively. You can do it every 3 or 4 days, one day every 3 or 4 days. If you cannot do it 6 days a month, you want to do it, you can do it 4 days a month, 2 days a month, 3 days a month, at least one day a month, or 1 day in 2 months, 1 day in 3 months, 1 day in 4, 5, 6 months, 1 day in 12 months, at least one day. But if you cannot do it 6 days a month, you might want to try 1 day per week. Okay. Next one is, the text also has something to say on these lines, that when you stay hungry, it destroys the cancer cells or bad cells or bacteria in your body, which saves you from really harsh diseases, big diseases. And science has somewhat similar opinion, that staying hungry or staying on a caloric restriction can save you from many diseases, because it helps to. Because what happens in this, as per the religious or spiritual text, is that when you do not feed yourself, you are actually not feeding those cancer cells or the bad cells or the bacteria, so they die and your disease dies. Now, what Ayurveda has to say about this is that if you are doing a fast every 15 days, one in every 15 days, or like twice a month, then you can say, then you are like saving yourself from diseases. If you are not doing so, you are like going to get diseases. Okay, now what should we do? If I have low metabolism, should I keep it low? If I have high metabolism and there are so many disadvantages, am I going to live shorter? So should I try to lower my metabolism? The best answer would be, have a balance of it, and try to stick with what nature has given you. Perhaps it is best suitable for you. Don't try to, if you're a low metabolism guy, don't try to like shoot up your metabolism. If you're a really high metabolism guy, don't try to slow down your metabolism too much. Don't try to play with nature. Okay, that is the first thing. Secondly, if you're really too low on metabolism, you can increase it somewhat. If you're really too high on metabolism, you might want to decrease it somewhat. How? I'm going to talk in my future videos. But for now, understand that it is not that really high metabolism is the best thing on the planet or low metabolism is the worst thing on the planet. The best thing is to have a balance, a decent ideal life where you enjoy the life, where you enjoy your food, where you do not feel too hungry, where you are satisfied. So if you like the video, please like and comment, and you might want to share this video with your family and friends whom you care for, because it is hard to find such videos. I think I didn't find any such video actually. Anyways, you can share the video. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.